Welcome to our cPanel tutorial. To send and receive email, you need an email account. cPanel makes it easy to set up and manage email accounts. This video tutorial will show you how to manage existing email accounts on cPanel. If you want to see how to create an email account, we demonstrate that in another video. I'll drop a link in the description below. Let's go ahead and log in to cPanel. Here we are in the cPanel home interface. Let's scroll down to the email section and then click the email accounts icon. The email accounts interface will appear. The counter at the top of the interface says we have 8 accounts, and this account sales package has a limit of 25 accounts. So the counter shows we have 17 available accounts. This table lists the email accounts on this cPanel account. The search bar allows you to search for an email account. Just enter what you want to search for. I'll go ahead and clear the search bar. You can use these filters to search for all accounts, restricted accounts, accounts over their storage limit, or the system email account. The system email account receives email when a sender doesn't route it to a mailbox that exists. We'll talk about this account later. This pagination tool lets you flip through pages of accounts. Click this gear icon to set the number of accounts that will appear on a page. You can also sort the table by clicking on one of the headers. Let's look at an entry in this table. The More icon lets you see more details if any exist. To delete an email account, click Delete. Then click Delete again to delete this account permanently. But I don't want to do that right now, so let's click Cancel and close the details of this account. These checkboxes allow you to select multiple accounts and delete them all with the Delete button. Once again, I am going to cancel. Let's click this checkbox to deselect all the accounts. You can click Check Email to open the email account in Webmail. We'll go over Webmail in another video. I'll drop a link in the description. You can also get information about how to connect a device or client to this email account, but we'll go over those options in a little bit. Instead, let's manage the details of this account. Click Manage. The Manage an Email Account interface will appear. We see the email account at the top, and you can check email from this link. Let's say the user forgot their email password. We can set up a new password for them. Enter the password in the password text box. What did you type in there? Click the eyeball icon to reveal the password. Oh no, you can see my password. I better hide that again. The strength bar indicates the relative strength of the password you entered. You can also click Generate and have the system generate a strong password for you. Click the down arrow to configure other requirements for this password, such as minimum password length, uppercase letters, numbers, and symbols. To change an email account's mailbox quota, enter a new amount in the allocated storage space text box or select Unlimited. This is useful when a user's mailbox is near its quota and you want to give them more storage space. To suspend an account, use the options under Restrictions. You can select how you want to suspend the account, including whether or not they can receive email, send email, or log in. The difference between suspend and hold is that suspend does not allow the account to send any emails at all, while a hold allows the user to send an email to the server, but holds those messages in a queue until you unsuspend the account. Next, we have the plus addressing options. By default, the system will automatically create folders for you. We'll go over plus addressing in more detail later. For now, let's save our changes. If you want to make more changes to the account after you update it, select the Stay on this page after I click Update Email Settings checkbox. We will do that because I have more to show you. Let's click Update Email Settings. A success message will appear, and the account has been updated. Okay, this is what I wanted to show you. This sidebar has lots of useful links. Let's look at Free Up Email Storage. This brings up the Email Disk Usage interface. You can look for anything using up a lot of space in your account to get back under quota. We'll go over this interface in another video. There is the Manage Email Filters option. This lets you create rules on your account to send messages to a particular folder or delete them automatically. We'll go over this interface in another video. Then there is Send Automated Responses. This option allows you to create an automatic response to an incoming message. It's useful for vacation notices. Once again, we'll go over this interface in another video. To connect a mail client to your computer, tablet, or other mobile device, click Connect Devices. If you click any of these, your browser will download a script that you can click to configure your mail client for the account. If you do not see your mail client on this list, or you wish to set up your mail client manually, scroll down to the Mail Client Manual Settings section. It may help to understand a few terms you see on this page. POP3 downloads email to your computer. IMAP keeps your email stored on the server. SSL is an encryption method that secures connections to the email server. Okay, let's go back to the interface. Enter these settings into your email client during the setup process. You can also mail these instructions to an email account. Enter the email account and click Send. Let's go back to that Manage an Email Account interface. You can also configure your calendars and contacts here. I'll drop a link to our calendars and contacts documentation below. Finally, you can get additional help by clicking on the About This interface link. Let's go back to the Email Accounts interface and talk about the system email account. Remember, this is the account that receives email when a sender doesn't route it to a mailbox that exists. The system email address controls the shared address book for this cPanel account. Your domain's email accounts can use this shared address book for collaboration purposes. Set the toggle to on or off. By default, mailbox names are UTF-7 encoded, which means that the system saves these mailboxes to the file system as unencoded strings and breaks some types of email filters. Enable UTF-8 support to resolve these issues. Email addresses that use plus addressing will automatically create folders for those plus addresses. With plus addressing, you can create variations of your email address by adding a plus sign followed by a tag. This modified address will still deliver emails to your main inbox. For example, if your email is river@example.com, you can use river+news@example.com to sign up for newsletters. This can be useful for organizing your emails, tracking emails, and managing spam. You can set your email to create folders for plus addressing automatically. Enable this toggle to automatically create folders when this email address receives a message that uses plus addressing. This way, the system will place a message addressed to river+news@example.com in a new folder called News. I'll drop a link in the description below for more help with plus addressing. There are also links here to access webmail or manage the account's disk usage. Finally, you can also manage the routing options for the system address by clicking Manage Default Address. Again, we'll go over that in another video. The video links are in the description below. For more information about cPanel, your hosting platform of choice, visit our website at cPanel.net and on social media at cPanel. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.